Support for this and all the free content of Addressing Gettysburg is made possible by our patrons over at patreon.com/addressinggettysburg.
You're listening to Addressing Gettysburg.
This is the wayside marker on Little Round Top facing north westish. It is called the Union Fishhook. And there is a quote from First Lieutenant Frank A. Haskell, aide to Brigadier General John Gibbon. And we will start with that. On the whole, this was an admirable position to fight a defensive battle. You are standing on Little Round Top, looking north and west over the center of the battlefield. Much of the fighting on the second and third days of the battle was visible from here. The Union line of defense began here at the Round Tops and ran north along Cemetery Ridge to the edge of town, then curved east over Culp's Hill, not visible, forming a fishhook. Since it was an interior line, it was at least a mile shorter than the Confederate line and required fewer soldiers to maintain. The higher elevations of the Union line gave the Federals better fields of view, greater ranges for cannon, and required the Confederates to attack uphill, which slowed them down. The Confederate line of battle extended along Seminary Ridge and then curved east through the town, paralleling the Union line. And you have a map here showing the fishhook position and the Confederates surrounding it. You also have another panoramic shot that is looking basically north. It's the photograph of what you're seeing before you, and it has marked points on it, including South Mountain, the Emmitsburg Road, Seminary Ridge, Copse of Trees, Pennsylvania Memorial, and Cemetery Hill. I'm not going to read it to you. You got to come and do that yourself the next time you come and visit Gettysburg.